Hey everybody, it's Camera Tim and I'm going to show you this really cool OBS shader that allows you to manipulate colors in really cool ways and stuff. So if you've seen the previous version of this shader, you've seen that we can add subtractive saturation to OBS using this shader, but that did only limit you to two sliders, and I've added additional sliders that allow you to have much more control over your colors, specifically with your saturation. And if this is your first time seeing this, then you didn't miss anything. I mean, you did, but this one's better. So the man, the myth, the legend, Exeldro added this updated shader to his Shaderfilter plugin as of version 2.3.1. So if you go to the link in the description, and it'll take you right to the GitHub page where you can download the Shaderfilter plugin for your operating system as shown here. And once you've downloaded and installed the shader, assuming you had OBS closed when you installed it, we can go to whatever source we're going to apply it to, go to filters, and then add a filter, and then we're going to add a user-defined shader. So we're going to select this, and then we'll click load shader text from file, and then hit browse, and then scroll down to the HSL HSV saturation shader. We're gonna go ahead and open it. And if you've used the previous version, you'll know that there was an HSL saturation and HSV saturation slider. Now we have two different ones for each color space. If you aren't familiar with HSL and HSV, go up there. I can't point to it because OBS is limiting me. But there's a video up there in the corner that'll explain exactly what HSL and HSV are and why they matter here. But the TLDR is that HSL is additive, HSV is subtractive. Now the difference we have here is that we notice we have a gain slider and a gamma slider for each color space. Now what's the difference? To explain the difference, we're actually going to hop into Resolve. And I'm going to show you using a grayscale ramp how these adjustments differ, because it's the same exact operations we have here on the bottom left. Now, if you've color graded in Resolve before, you probably know that gain adjusts mostly the highlights, gamma does mostly midtones, lift does mostly shadows, and offset just moves everything up and down evenly. But what is actually happening when we are moving these adjustments? Turns out they're just math operations. And gain is actually very simple to understand. It's just a multiplier, meaning whatever gain is how much it'll multiply the pixel value by. So let's just hypothetically say that black equals 0 and white equals 1. We have a perfect line here that describes everything in between. And let's just say at the middle here we have 0.5. So if you multiplied 0.5 by 2, you would get 1, right? So if we moved gain to 2, then we would see this center point move to here to the top. And let's see that happen here. And there we go. The center point right here is at 1 because we're multiplying 0.5 by 2, as seen here in the gain. And the same thing is true if you take it the other way. If you multiply by 0.5, it'll essentially cut it in half. And that's really all gain is. Now, gamma is a little bit more difficult to understand because it's an exponential adjustment technically. And the actual mathematical operation is the input caret 1 divided by gamma. And if you don't want to do the math and figure out why it works or how it works, basically what that means is that whatever is 0 will stay 0 and whatever is 1 will stay 1, but everything in between will move. So if we move our gamma here, you can see that 0 and 1, so basically black and white, are staying at their exact positions, but everything else in between is moving, with whatever's in the mid-range moving the most. And then offset is just literally moving every single thing up and down evenly, and your lift is the inverse of gain, so it moves everything except for 1. And this is actually why we can't feature lift and offset into this shader, because they move 0. Why does that matter? Imagine you had a saturation value of 0, meaning there was no saturation there. Well, what happens if you move that value? It will completely break. Like that. So this is why we can only feature gain and gamma in this shader. But what's nice is we can use both adjustments to play against each other to shape what our saturation should look like. So we can make our own curves, essentially, something like that. So if we did this in our shader, what would happen? Well, let's go back to OBS now. And let's go back to our shader. And let's say we move our gain down. I'm going to make sure I'm in order 2. By the way, order, if you haven't seen the first video, order number 1 is both HSL and HSV blended together as an average. Order number 2 is HSL first, and then HSV is applied after that. And then order 3 is HSV applied first, and then HSL applied second. So I'm going to stick with order 2 for now. But let's just move our saturation gain down, and then our saturation gamma up. Now, what's the net result? we basically compress our colors in a way. And if we pull up a vector scope, and if you haven't seen a vector scope video, I have another video over here talking about how vector scopes and waveforms work and how these color tools in OBS can much better help you monitor what your colors and exposure actually look like. But essentially, a vector scope just shows where colors are going and shifting towards red, magenta, blue, cyan, green, and yellow. But if we turn this on and off, we can see that the ranges in here are being pushed out a lot more, where some of our reds are actually coming inwards slightly. We can kind of see that in a little Pokeball here. If we do a more drastic example here, pushing this out really far, now we're really compressing our colors pretty hardcore, because now we can shape our saturation in a way we haven't been able to before. And I'll just reset these. And this is the difference with HSL response. It's very additive, so it gives a very different flavor of how the adjustments are being applied. Now, really quickly, to describe what I mean by additive and subtractive, in case you are not familiar with this concept, subtractive saturation really comes from film or print, where you start with something that's white, and then you use colors like cyan, magenta, and yellow to subtract light information to produce different colors. Whereas additive saturation starts with something that's black, like your monitor or your phone or a TV or something like that, where it starts out black and the only way it gets color is by adding red, green, and blue into it. So we can see how these adjustments differ. When we add saturation in HSV, all of our values are only going down, nothing goes up, so that way we don't clip anything up top, and that works with both gain and gamma. Whereas in HSL, we do get additive saturation because it's attempting to separate colors more to create something that looks more vivid. But these can be used in tandem as well. So we can take away some saturation in HSL, push it in HSV, give it a little bit more of a deeper, denser look or denser color, and we can get some really pleasant results without really clipping or pushing any of our colors too far. Like so. So I really hope you get a lot of use out of this shader, and hopefully is something that is useful for you, for your streams or whatever you're recording. And it's not exclusive to just webcams. You can use this for whatever you want. But this is a great way to control an environment where you have a lot of colors that are very heavily saturated, and then you have areas that aren't. You can control your colors much better and compress them together so that everything looks the way you want it to, and it has a much cleaner look. I would love to see what you guys use this shader for, so please leave a comment, and any questions you have, feel free to ask as well. And if you didn't click on those videos before because you wanted to watch the rest of this, but now you want to watch them, well, here they are! It's almost like I planned for this end screen to be more saturated. Okay, alright, you know, nope, I'm out. Okay. Oh yeah, this is Camera Tim signing out. One could say this gained a lot of shade. Oh boy.